Learning to code is hard, but the first thing you need to get right is to learn the fundamentals. That is why today I'm going to show you 5 tips so you can become a master of writing for loops. This video is sponsored by ZEGOCLOUD. ZEGOCLOUD's social solutions help you build one-on-one and group video calls, live audio rooms, and social live streaming into your apps to help your users connect and have fun together. Their education solutions help you build virtual classrooms of all types and all sizes. By adding collaborative whiteboards that work perfectly in sync with live audio and video, screen sharing and live sharing, you can make your online education platform more engaging and effective. ZEGOCLOUD also provides live shopping solutions that can help brands and merchants bring in-store shopping experiences online. For example, in a shoppable live streams, hosts can showcase a product for modeling it and demonstrating how it works in front of the camera and engage with the viewers by answering their questions and guiding them through the buying process. But there's more. ZEGOCLOUD's fitness solutions enable fitness businesses to build online gyms and provide different types of online fitness services, including virtual fitness classes, live streaming fitness sessions, and one-on-one private fitness coaching, workout together, and much, much more. ZEGOCLOUD is also great for collaboration. They provide remote collaboration solutions for building productive remote workforces, enabling teams of all sizes to work from home or anywhere and collaborate effectively with each other by using voice and video calls, real-time messaging, screen sharing, file sharing, whiteboards, and other tools. Integration is as simple as it gets. Get started with 4 lines of code and embed engaging real-time video, voice, and in-app chat experiences into your apps. Click the link below in the description. Before we get into the 5 tips, let's just remind ourselves how we can write for loops in Swift. So what I have created here is just a brand new Swift UI project. And what I'm going to add, instead of this image and the text, I'm going to add a button so we can basically call that for loop. So we're going to run our for loop right over there. And for the action, actually auto completion is failing right over here, but basically that's it. I'm going to create tip number 0, and tip number 0 will be basically a reminder of how for loops can be created. So we are going to create a function here, func tip 0. And I'm going to go through all of the ways that you can create for loops inside Swift. So basically you need to know the syntax. So I'm going to go through. The first one will be for I in 0 and till, so the 2 dots. And then we need to have an array that we can iterate through. So for that, I'm going to create a private state variable called names. And it will be just a simple string array of either Bob, and maybe let's just add also Claire, there we go. So we are going to go and iterate from 0 till the count of names minus 1. So there we go, we just select count right over there. And then we want to grab our current name, so let name equals names at index I, and I'm going to just simply print it out. So let's just print out name. Okay, let's build it run and see how this looks like. Basically, when I tap on that button, we should just be printed out in the console, just either Bob and Claire. So let's just wait for this. Let's tap on the run for loop button, either Bob and Claire. There we go. So that's one way of declaring a for loop, but that's kind of the oldest way of doing this. Let's create another for loop. In our case, we are going to use for name in names. And as you can see, Xcode 14 is kindly giving us this code snippet. So it's just adding it there. So we just go print out our name and build and run again. So we should see the same output in the console log, run for loop, Ada, Bob and Claire. That's really nice. But finally, I want to show you my favorite one, and that is names.forEach for each, and we are going to get back a name in, and let's just print our name. So yeah, of course, the output will be the same. So that's kind of a revision of how we could just write for loops. Now it's time for the five tips that will make you master in writing for loops. So here we go. Tip number one is to use break whenever you need it. So yeah, take a break. But in this time, we are going to take a break inside a for loop. So let's create function tip one. And I'm going to change it right over here, so the button will run that function as its action. And what I'm going to do is basically iterate through the array of the names array, and I want to see when we find Bob, basically the second one, not the last one, I want to break. I don't want to move forward to any other elements, like Claire in this case. So what I'm going to do is just, again, use the for name in names, and first of all, let's print out our name, and then if the name equals Bob, then I'm going to print out breaking, because we are going to use the break keyword, so we are not going to move forward in the iteration of the for loop. So there we go, either Bob and breaking. It's really nice. Now, tip number two, if you have 2D arrays, please do use nested for loops. So here we go. We are going to create, first of all, let's create our 2D array. So private state, and let's see, 2D array. And again, I'm going to go with the names. Let's have our first one with Ada and then Bob. There we go. We need these to be string values. And then let's have another array and then Claire, and then Dan, then pun intended. Okay, so we have our 2D array, and now it's time to create our function. That is tip number two. Let's just add that also onto our action. So what we need to do is just iterate through the 2D array and print out all of the names. So let's just use here my favorite one. So 2D array for each. We are going to have an array of names. So again, I'm going to go through that array with another for each. And this time around, it will be name. And let's just print it out. So print out name. Let's build and run with Command R. And now we should see either Bob, Claire, and Dan. So that is tip number two, 2D arrays with nested for loops. Now, tip number three is to use map with arrays. So let's just create our function right over here, tip three. There we go. And what I'm going to do is just map basically this array names. I'm going to grab all of these names and I'm going to create a new array with their first character. So A, B, and C in our case. So let's see, that will be tip number three. And let's see, so let's create our array of characters and I will name this first letters. First letters, there we go. And we are going to grab our names array and let's just map, and we are going to grab our each and every name, and we are going to get back our name dot first. That's a character. And finally, we are going to print out our first letters. And if you were paying attention, you will definitely see that these first characters are optional. So if I tap on run for loop, as you can see, it's optional A, optional B, and optional C. Because yeah, maybe that string could be an empty string, so they will not be a first character. Okay, tip number four, filter. So you can filter these arrays. And what I'm going to do is just grab all of the elements in this array that start with the character B. So it should be an array of Bob. Okay, so let's create that. First of all, I'm going to add in here tip number four, and let's create that function so we don't have any errors. Func, and that will be tip four, not two functions, one function, And that is called tip four. So let names starting with B. This will be an array, so we are going to get only one element, but still it's going to be an array. So names starting with B, that's names dot filter. So filter, which one? Let's just type out filter. Yes, this is the one. And then we are going to grab our name, and the value right over here is name dot first equals our character of B. So now we just simply print out our names starting with B. So again, let's build and run, and let's see if we get this Bob. And there we go, we have an array and it has only one element. Okay, so final tip number four is sorting. So for the sorting, I want to first of all create an unsorted array, and let's let that be again another private state variable, unsorted names, and let this be maybe Bob, and then Claire, and then Ada. Okay, so this is an unsorted names list according to their first character, of course. So what I'm going to create is a function called tip five, and that will sort our array. So let's just have that on the button. So let sorted names equals, we are grabbing the unsorted names and then go sorted by, and we're going to have here two elements, that's name 0 and name 1. And what I want to do is just go name 0 is less than name 1. Okay, finally, let's just print out the sorted names. Okay, let's build and run and see this in action. So we should get that sorted, Ada, Bob, and Claire. So it's really nice. Now you are a power user of for loops in Swift. And if you'd want to know how I learned how to code for hours on end, go ahead, check out this video right over here.